With the hope that you will all be well, let's start today's lecture. In previous lecture, we studied the some basics of thermodynamics property relations. While discussing the partial derivative, partial differential relations, and reciprocity and cyclic relation. However, in this lecture, we will move one step further and discuss the Maxwell relations. At the end of this lecture, we will also discuss the Clapeyron equation. It will come as no surprise that some properties such as temperature, pressure, volume, and mass can be measured directly. Other properties such as density and specific volume can be determined from these using some simple relations. However, properties such as internal energy, enthalpy, and entropy are not so easy to determine because they cannot be measured directly or related to easily measurable properties through some simple relations. Therefore, it is essential that we develop some fundamental relations between commonly encountered thermodynamic properties and express these properties that cannot be measured directly in terms of easily measurable properties. So let's start. The Maxwell relations. The equations that relate the partial derivatives of properties like pressure, specific volume, temperature, and entropy of a simple compressible system to each other are called the Maxwell relations. They are obtained from four Gibbs equations by exploiting the exactness of the differentials of thermodynamic properties. Students can see the details of Gibbs relations in Chapter 7 of book Thermodynamics and Engineering Approach by Michael A. Balls and Youngus A. Sengen. However, the two properties of the Gibbs relations can be expressed as du is equal to Tds minus Pdv. And the second expression is dh is equal to Tds plus VdP. Here in these expressions, U symbolize the internal energy, T represents the temperature, S is entropy, and P and V are the pressure and specific volume. However, in second equation, H represents the enthalpy. The other two Gibbs relations are based on two new combination properties, the Helmholtz function A and the Gibbs function G. That can be defined as A is equal to U minus Ts, and the second one, that is Gibbs function G, is equal to H minus Ts. So after differentiating, we get the following expression: dA is equal to dU minus Tds minus SdT. However, the second expression can be written as dG is equal to dH minus Tds minus SdT. So after simplifying the preceding relations by using the equations dU is equal to Tds minus Pdv and dH is equal to Tds plus Vdp, we obtain the other two Gibbs relations for simple compressible systems. However, the above expressions can also be written as dU minus Tds is equal to minus Pdv. And the second expression can be written as dH minus Tds is equal to Vdp. So after replacing dU minus Tds with minus Pdv, and the first equation can be expressed as dA is equal to minus SdT minus Pdv. And in second equation, by replacing dH minus Tds with Vdp, we get the equation as dG is equal to minus SdT plus Vdp. So a careful examination of the four Gibbs relations reveals that they are of the form dZ is equal to mdx plus ndy. And as we already discussed in previous lecture, we can write it as partial m over partial y, while x is held constant, is equal to partial n over partial x, while y is held constant. Since from the above expressions, u, h, a, and g are properties and thus have exact differentials. So applying the above expression, we can write these equations as the first equation of Gibbs function can be written as partial t over partial v, while s is held constant, is equal to minus partial p over partial s while v is held constant. However, from second equation we get partial t over partial p while s is held constant is equal to partial v over partial s while p is held constant. The third expression can be written as partial s over partial v while t is held constant is equal to partial p over partial t while v is held constant. And finally, the fourth equation can be expressed as partial s over partial p while t is held constant is equal to minus partial v over partial t while p is held constant. These expressions are called the Maxwell relations. However, these Maxwell relations are extremely valuable in thermodynamics because they provide a means of determining the changes in entropy, which cannot be measured directly. By simply measuring the changes in properties, pressure, specific volume, and temperature. Here it is important to note that the Maxwell relations given here are limited to simple compressible systems. However, other similar relations can be written just as easily for non-simple systems such as those involving electrical, magnetic, and other effects. So after deriving the Maxwell relations, now we will see our next topic, the Clapeyron equation. The Maxwell relations have far-reaching implications in thermodynamics and are often used to derive useful thermodynamic relations. However, the Clapeyron equation is one such relation and it enables us to determine the enthalpy change associated with the phase change, such as the enthalpy of vaporization from a knowledge of pressure, specific volume, and temperature data alone. For this, consider the Maxwell relation or the third Maxwell relation, partial P over partial T while V is held constant is equal to partial S over partial V while T is held constant. During a phase change process, the pressure is the saturation pressure, which depends on the temperature only and is independent of the specific volume. So we can express it as saturation pressure is a function of saturation temperature only. Therefore, the partial derivative partial P over partial T while V is held constant can be expressed as a total derivative dP over dT, which is the slope of the saturation curve on the PT diagram at a specified saturation state, as shown in figure here. This slope is independent of the specific volume and thus it can be treated as a constant during the integration of the above expression between two saturation states at the same temperature. However, for an isothermal liquid vapor phase change process, for example, the integration yields SF minus SG minus SF is equal to dP over dT VG minus VF. So here, as we already discussed in previous slides, here S is the entropy and V is the specific volume. However, the subscript G and F actually represents the saturated vapor and saturated liquid states respectively. However, the above expression can also be written as dP over dT is equal to SFG over VFG. Here, FG is the evaporation process or phase change process. So during this process, the pressure also remains constant. So we can express the Gibbs equation as dH is equal to T dS plus V dP. During this process, the pressure is held constant or considered as constant. So the Gibbs equation or expression reduces to dH is equal to T dS. Or after integration, it is written as dH integral F to G and integral F to G T dS. So after integration, it can be written as HFG is equal to TSFG. Now substituting this result into the expression dP over dT is equal to SFG over VFG, or replacing SFG with HFG over T, we obtain the expression as dP over dT is equal to HFG over TVFG, which is called the Clapeyron equation after the French engineer and physicist E. Clapeyron. This is an important thermodynamic relation since it enables us to determine the enthalpy of vaporization at a given temperature. By simply measuring the slope of the saturation curve on a PT diagram and the specific volume of saturated liquid and saturated vapor at the given temperature. However, the Clapeyron equation is applicable to any phase change process that occurs at constant temperature and pressure. It can be expressed in a general form as dP over dT is equal to H12 process 1-2 over T V process 1-2, where the subscript 1 and 2 indicates the two phases. However, the Clapeyron equation can be simplified for liquid vapor and solid vapor phase changes by utilizing some approximations. At low pressures, specific volume of saturated vapor much greater than specific volume of saturated liquid. And thus we can write it as V of Fg approximately equal to Vg. By treating the vapor as an ideal gas, we have Vg is equal to RT over P. So substituting these approximations into the preceding equation, we find dP over dT is equal to pH of Fg over RT square. However, this equation can also be expressed as dP over P is equal to HFG over R dT over T square. However, for small temperature intervals, H of Fg can be treated as a constant at some average values. Then integrating this equation between two saturation states yields natural log of P2 over P1 approximately equal to H of Fg over R 1 over T1 minus 1 over T2. So this equation is called the Clapeyron-Clausius equation, and it can be used to determine the variation of saturation pressure with temperature. So in this lecture, we studied the Maxwell relations. We also see the Clapeyron equation and Clapeyron-Clausius equation. I hope this would be very helpful for you. Thank you for your attention.